the management of Jodhpur Institute of Engineering and Technology, Jodhpur, for hosting the program. And I want to thank Dr. Kusumlata Agarwal Madam and Dr. Ankit Ji for inviting me. Before I formally start the program, I want to know about the profile of the participants. So how many, means what is the majority of participants? Are they from tier one or tier two or management or diploma?
Sir, majority of the participants are from the tier two, because we are affiliated to the Rajasthan Technical University. But at the same time, our college has now become the first autonomous institution of complete Rajasthan in engineering field under the Bikaner Technical University. Great. So majority of the participants are from tier two institution, and majority of are from engineering colleges.
Okay. So I would focus my presentation on tier two.
Yes.
But I would be happy to respond to questions of tier one if one or two participants from there, from diploma institute or maybe from management institute or pharmacy institute, no issue. Dear friends, let me start how to prepare effective self-assessment report. This is the topic given to me, and this is self-assessment report, but actually it is the preparation for outcome-based education. It is the preparation for NBA accreditation, which is based on the philosophy of achievements and outcomes. It is not based on processes like ISO certification or other accreditation certificates. So first of all, we must appreciate that in our institute, we must have, please mute your video, sir, it is distracting. Thank you, sir. I was talking about, we must have quality systems. I always say that quality is by design, it is not by chance. And NBA accreditation is nothing, but it is the certificate for the quality of the program. So quality by design, not by chance. So if you are preparing, or if you are interested to apply for NBA accreditation for one program or for more than one programs, you must have systems. Quality by design, not by chance. So for everything, you must have well-designed systems which are perfect one, whether it is admission process or curriculum development or curriculum implementation or examination system or guidance and counseling of the students or mentoring of the students or organizing entrepreneurship development programs, are organizing industrial training, are assigning major and minor projects to the students. Everything should be by design and not by chance. This is the fundamental principle before you go for self-assessment report preparation. The second principle is related to continuous improvement. What you have been doing in previous years, there should be improvement in that. If you don't find continuous improvement in your achievements and in your performance at institute level, at department level, and even at individual level, you should not start preparing for a self-assessment report. Then the third principle is value addition. Are you having a culture in your institute to add value to your processes and to your outputs or outcomes. If you are doing it, then it is good. Otherwise, first you should do that, and after that you should apply, means you should start preparing for the accreditation. Then there is a principle of problem prevention. If you are having n number of problems in your institute and in your department, please try to solve those problems in such a way so that these problems do not occur in your institute or in your department in future. So NBA is related to problem prevention. And since we all have engineering and scientific background, so we know that we need to solve the problem from its roots. So I would request you to design the mechanism and systems to prevent the problems, rather than every day morning having problems and solving them and appreciating yourself that you have solved two problems or three problems or big problem or complex problem or like that. Then another principle for quality education is working in a team. In most of the institutions, we don't work in a team. And that is why we are unable to produce synergy. We are unable to conceive change and innovation, and we are unable to implement it effectively and efficiently as an institute or as a department. So there is a need to work in a team. So you must have a team structure instead of hierarchical structure. Then another principle is that you should do the benchmarking. So whatever requirements are there from NBA accreditation point of view, you should try to benchmark your performance and you should prepare plans accordingly. Then another principle of NBA accreditation is say, do, prove, and improve. Say, do, prove, and improve. Whatever you want to do, please prepare a plan for that, or prepare a system for that, or design a process for that. And the system or process should be perfect. That is saying. Then do. Say do. S-D-P. So do. Whatever you do, it should be according to your plan. That is doing part. So you are not doing randomly. You are not doing casually. But you are doing, you are performing, you are implementing your plans. Say, do, and prove. How do you prove? So whatever plans you have prepared, whatever systems you have designed, all those should be properly documented. And after that, you have implemented. So when you implement anything, there will be evidences. Actually, evidences are the byproduct of the implementation. So there is no need to create or fabricate any evidence. Only thing is it has to be documented. So my humble request is that whatever you are doing, maybe a very small thing, try to document it in a proper way. And for documentation also, you should have a system so that it is not haphazard and you don't use the casual process. You do the complete documentation in effective and efficient manner. So say, do, and prove. But documentation doesn't mean wastage of paper. You can keep soft copies of most of the things. This is the era of ICT. So most of the things you can keep in soft form. So please do not waste papers. They spoil the environment. Say, do, prove. Once you have implemented one cycle, then you have to improve. Now you are a person with experience of one cycle of implementation. So your experiences should go in improving the next cycle of design, implementation, and evaluation. So these are some of the things which are very, very necessary when you want to prepare self-assessment report for your respective programs and at your institute level. So these are the some principles which we should keep in mind. These principles are not written anywhere. We have evolved these principles by our experiences. So with this opening remark, I would like to request you to go through the presentation. I am giving the copy to the host institute, so you can download it maybe from the classwork and you can go through it. And tomorrow also I am having a session, so if something is there we can discuss and we can clarify. So with this opening remark, I would like to start my formal presentation. But again, that is not on preparation of self-assessment report, that is on approaches of preparation. So I would like to submit here that it has happened in our country that many institutions have simply filled up the self-assessment report and applied. It is not going to work. It is not going to bring you accreditation certificate. So you need to do a lot of preparation, as I have shared in my opening remark. So which are the approaches? So you should do number of creativity sessions at institute level, at department level, and maybe in small groups and sections. So the very first, my PowerPoint visible to you?
No, sir.
I will check. Now it is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So I was talking about conducting creativity sessions. So you should conduct many creativity sessions, since we are shifting from input and process based to outcome based. So we need to do brainstorming session. This is the commonly known technique of creativity. So if you are not trained in that, please receive training and do brainstorming at department level, institute level, and program level. If you are having more programs in a department than one program, then meetings. There is a need to conduct a number of meetings so that things are clear to you and people are aware about each and everything. And there is a sharing of information and you can take major decisions. So in this way, you can obtain the commitment of each and every stakeholder of the institute for quality education. So looking to the need of type of preparation, you should conduct meetings. NBA accreditation should not be the business of 3, 4, 5 persons in the institute, but I always say that quality is responsibility of all. So everybody should bear the responsibility. And for that, we need to conduct a number of meetings. Then discussions. Since the outcome-based education is new to the whole country, and it may be new to the institute also, so we can organize many discussions on different themes, and we can resolve the issues, or we can take effective decision, or we can see the situation from all aspects. Then we need to conduct workshops also, so that in workshops, in a participative manner, we can come out with the different outcomes. I will talk about it. And these are known to everyone. Then consultations. You can also do the consultation workshops with sister institutions, and you can know many things from them. Then coming to, it may be individual consultation also. Then training. Training is very, very important. Without training, you cannot develop the abilities. And whatever is there in the NBA accreditation process, you cannot do it using your common sense, because common sense has got many limitations. And it is very easy for us to appreciate that any change requires competence and commitment. So that can be developed through training. Then there should be number of presentations. As I told you, that we have to work in variety of groups and variety of themes. So the outputs of the group should be presented in a plenary session, and it should be known to everyone. And through presentation, we can communicate, and at the same time, we can validate it from a bigger population. Then experience sharing. Suppose in one engineering college, 6 departments are there. They all are preparing for the accreditation. What are their experiences? So that can be shared with each other. Then another very important aspect is that if you want to really get the accreditation, you must visit the institute which is having accreditation. So in this way, you develop your abilities and you develop your confidence to get the, means to prepare for the self-assessment report. Now, very important point, which is not happening in many of the institutions. I always request technical institutions ask their faculty members and staff members, especially the officials who are holding portfolios, even non-technical persons like accountant or establishment, administrative officer or like that, sports officer, are like that, they must visit the NBA website. And I always tell my fellow professionals that before you start preparing for the NBA accreditation, please study the general manual. Please ask everyone to study it. This is available on NBA website free of cost. That is general manual. It is issued in 2019. Manual, it is old one, but it is also available with the on NBA website for a specific program. So for diploma, for undergraduate, for PG, for pharmacy, for management, this manual is available. Then comes pre-qualifiers. There are many institutions who start preparing without assessing their eligibility and pre-qualifiers. And after 1 year preparation or 6 months preparation, or after filling the self-assessment report, they come to know that they don't even satisfy the pre-qualifiers. If you don't satisfy the pre-qualifiers, you will not be able to file the application with the NBA. Then study the self-assessment report in totality. So self-assessment report is a question paper. And evaluation guidelines is a model answer. So I would request that please see the question paper, please see the model answer, and try to prepare your institute and programs so that you satisfy the requirements of model answer. That is evaluation guidelines. If time permits, I will discuss each and every thing. So this is the prerequisite that all the faculty members and officers and in charges of section must go through these documents. Please note it. Then I would request that at institute level, there should be a team, and this team should be properly trained with the right kind of person, not for certification, but for developing the competence, so that the team can take up responsibility and the team can guide the whole institute for the accreditation process. Similarly, there is a need to constitute team at department level, so that at department level the team takes care of different criteria. These teams should assess the performance of the institute and performance of the program on different criteria which has been given in the pre-qualifiers and in the self-assessment report. And after doing the assessment, they should see how much points they get. So I think you might be aware, if you get 600 or more points, of course with certain limitations, then only you get the accreditation for 3 years. So please do the self-assessment and try to see what are your strengths, what are your weaknesses, where is the scope for improvement, and what is the threat. So this team constituted at institute level and at department level should do it. I have already talked about, so you are aware that if you get 600 and more, you get accreditation for 3 years. If you get 750 and more out of 1,000, you get accreditation for 6 years, of course, with certain other conditions also. It is all written in the manual. Okay. So if you get less than 600 points, then you should try to improve. And I want to say that many times the institutions take excuses. We could not receive fund from the government, or we could not receive the request from here or there. So that is not acceptable to the NBA team. Okay, all these team members and officials should be trained. And for that purpose, you can organize 3-day workshop or 5-day workshop for faculty members and officials. So everybody is at same length, everybody speaks same language, and everybody is aware about the shared progress which is being made towards NBA accreditation. You can clarify the concept, benefits, efforts, everything you can clarify in the workshop, and then you can make them apprise that it is the responsibility of everyone. Quality is the responsibility of all. I also say that the strength of the chain is the strength of the weakest link. If, and you know that the visiting team do the sampling, and in sampling, if those teachers are there who are not prepared and who are not aware, that will spoil the whole show of the institute, of the department, and of the program. So every link must be equally strong, whether the person has joined recently or whether the person is going to retire. NBA team does sampling and they ask the questions. So they may do sampling in this way. The persons who are very close to retirement, one person from them, one person from mid-level, and one person from newly joined persons. And if all the three persons are not aware, then the whole show will be a bad show. Okay, so this is what I wanted to share through this presentation, and I think I spoke enough. Now I would be with you for 3 to 5 minutes, and I would like to take up your questions so that you are also comfortable and I also know the entry behavior of yours. So you can post the questions in the chat, or someone can read the questions for me, or in a disciplined way you can unmute and you can ask the question.
I think the participants can post their queries into the chat box, and one by one I would be taking from the chat box.
Yeah. You can have any system, or they can unmute in disciplined way and they can ask, no issue.
Okay.
We'll give them permission. Yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Any question from anyone?
Sir, you told two, three very good things, such as the strength of chain is the strength of weakest link, basically. So sometimes we are stuck with those. So
that will spoil the whole show.
Yeah, exactly. So I feel that tackling those weak links is very much necessary. So do you have anything in your mind or any suggestions on this? That please.
In the very beginning I told you, conduct number of creativity sessions, meetings, discussions, presentations, experience sharings, and plenary sessions. So this is one way to keep everyone at same level and at same pace, number one. Number two, if you think that these are the identified people who are weak link, give them some responsibility so that they pick up and they develop themselves. That is second thing. Third thing is that please conduct the mock session and make them as a sample. So they will realize that they are the weakest link and they should do preparation. So this is how, these are the ways and means of doing the things. And what I feel, workshop mode is a very good mode. In that mode, you can invite everyone to share about the accreditation process, share about the task which has been assigned to them, share about the outcome of the task, share about their experiences of working on a particular task. So there's a need to work in a team. So this is how we can do it.
Yes, sir.
In my institute, what do? Suppose I have to, as I told you, I have conducted 100 training programs on NBA accreditation only. So what I do, I make a team of 2-3 persons. I take the lead, and the second person is an active person. Third person acts as a participant in first program. In second program, the second person will take the lead, and the third person who was working as a participant will become the active member of the training team. And in third program, that fellow will become the leader. So this is how, means we rotate the responsibility and we rotate the leadership, and this is how we develop in my institute.
Thank you so much, sir. I think you have given your best ideas for tackling the weak links in the chain, and we will surely do it. Creativity sessions, assign the responsibility, conduct mock sessions, and definitely the last one is rotate the responsibilities, rotate the leadership. So thank you so much, sir. I think one question is from Dr. Kamal K. Vyas. You talked about the problem prevention. So how it is, and if you can elaborate with the help of one example.
Very simple. We all are having engineering and scientific background. So there are two things. The very first thing is you design the perfect system so that there is no scope for a problem. If I take the example of curriculum design. So if you are designing the curriculum from the philosophy of outcome-based education point of view, so in the design itself, we have prevented many problems. That is what we do in our engineering also, and in science also. So that is one thing. Please try to design each and every system at the institute level. It should not be a casual approach. We all are learned professors. We teach design subjects to our students, and we compel them to follow concept, rules, regulations, models, process, tools, techniques, and we are not using it in our institute. So if it is a mentoring system, so complete mentoring system should be designed and 1 year action plan should be prepared so that everything happens as per plan. There is no surprise. There are no surprises like that. So the very first answer to this question is, please try to have design, and that design should be known to everyone through awareness, and that design should be available on your website also. And I always say to my fellow professionals, prepare two handbooks. One handbook for teacher and one handbook for students. And in that handbook, put all types of academic, administrative, all types of things. So most of the things are available with them, maybe in soft copy. I'm not saying ki you get it printed and all that. So that is one approach. The second approach, which is a very common approach and which has been taken from the medical field, we try to analyze the problem and reach to the root cause, and then treat the root cause. It will consume less resources, less efforts, and less time, and at the same time you are able to solve the problem. So if I cut a tree from the stem, it will again grow, but if I uproot the tree, it cannot grow. It's like that. Although I have taken wrong example, we should not do that, but yes, treat the problem at its root so that the problem doesn't occur. So these are the two approaches which are predominantly used in technical institutions also. And I always say that have a design for everything and make an action plan for everything for at least 1 year. So there are no surprises, or there is no casual approach. Everybody is aware, principal, head of department, dean, faculty members, students, if they have to participate in mentoring session on such and such date, it will be organized at such and such place, and this person will be the resource person for that. So like that, everything is by design. So in this way, we can prevent many problems, I tell you. Even 95% problems we can prevent if we don't have casual approach, if we go by design. I suppose I have responded.
Yes. Very nicely you explained the problem prevention. And definitely knowing the root cause is going to solve this. So we are having more questions. One is about handling of the new joinees into the department at the time of NBA accreditation. And one is about the handling of students, because the accreditation team interacts with the students. Then these are two questions related to the handling. Yes, sir.
Yeah. In Nitter Bhopal, we conducted 4 weeks induction training program for technical teachers. And these programs are designed from outcome-based education philosophy point of view and from NBA requirement point of view. So most of the state governments, they are sponsoring their teachers to attend our programs, induction phase 1 and phase 2 of 4 weeks duration. So before they join or after their joining, immediately they have to undergo this 4 weeks training. So they are properly inducted in the system and they are properly inducted in the profession. So this is what we do. Now coming to the teachers, inducted teachers for NBA accreditation. So I would always recommend that sponsor them for attending training programs conducted on outcome-based education or related themes by premier institutes of the country. So even they may take lead. And in Maharashtra, especially in Maharashtra, we have seen that newly recruited teachers took the lead for NBA preparation, because for 4 weeks they have been rigorously trained, so they were aware about each and every nitty-gritty of NBA accreditation. So this is how we can properly induct the teachers. मैं इसको ऐसा भी बोलता हूँ कि जब हमारे घर में नई बहू आती है तो we do the socialization. Means we orient her, everybody orients her about the culture of the family. So I always say कि our teachers and our students should be properly oriented through awareness workshop, maybe through education workshop, maybe through training, like that. So this will build up a good culture related to outcome-based education. And everybody get into it, and everybody will try to further it. So this is what we do in our NITR also. And we request all other institutions and our participants to do it. Proper socialization of teachers and students. पहले ही दिन से उनको चौक हाथ में नहीं दे देना चाहिए. They should be properly inducted so that they will be with you and they will commit to their task, and they will commit to their goals and even the department and institutional goals. So training, awareness, education, and give them responsibility. Unless you give them responsibility, they will not get into the mainstream of the state. So that is very much required. Same is the case for the students. I conduct a orientation program for even tools and malis and drivers for NBA accreditation. Because earlier, that driver used to bring the NBA team from hotel to institute. So whatever driver speaks about, I am talking before 2013, but whatever driver speaks about the institute, it matters so much, because that is the first impression about the institute in the minds of the evaluation team. So I used to, means for in many institutions in Maharashtra, I have educated drivers, malis, and even peons. Okay, how do they behave with the team members while serving, even maybe water? And if somebody asks something, how do they respond and what is their body language? It also matters so much. So orientation is very, very important. Training, awareness, education, and proper induction is very important. It is a socialization. So we should do the socialization. Otherwise, the newly recruited teachers or our students will never get into our culture and our practices. I suppose I have taken much of time, but this is very, very important.
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Yes, sir. All the queries are answered. One question is, NBA is valid for how many years? I think it is for 3 and 6 years.
No, you. Means 3 years or 6 years.
Or, yes, sir.
How many years you get? It all depends on that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So 3 or 6 years. Yeah. Any other question, please?
No, sir. I think we had answered all the questions.
Okay. Fine. Great. So thank you very much for not asking very difficult question to me. Now coming to the self-assessment report, which is my main theme. So dear friends, I would like to say here that please do the groundwork as I told you. And first of all, before filling the self-assessment report, you should work on the pre-qualifiers. And I think someone might have talked about pre-qualifiers yesterday.
Yes, sir.
Great. So now we directly come to the self-assessment report. So first you ensure that you qualify in pre-qualifiers on essential criteria and essential criteria and desirable parameters. So that is the prerequisite. If you are not able to do that, please try to work on pre-qualifiers, and simultaneously you can work on self-assessment report also. But I want to say here that it is not the filling of self-assessment report and getting the NBA accreditation. NBA accreditation is not for self-assessment report. NBA accreditation is for quality education on the parameters. And NBA accreditation is on the basis of level of implementation of outcome-based education as a whole in your institute, in your department, and in your program. Self-assessment report is simply a document which is communicating that you are having that outcome-based system in your institute. There are many people who appoint consultants. There are many people who copy self-assessment report of other institutions which got accreditation, and they think that they will also get. So this is not going to happen. So it is not the self-assessment report, but it is your achievements related to various criteria of accreditation for your program and at institute level. So please note it. With this caution, I want to discuss on self-assessment report. But self-assessment report is a very big format. I would request you, you means to participants, if they want to know any specific thing, they can put it in chat. By that time, I will open the self-assessment report for tier two, which I have downloaded from the NBA site, and then I will talk about it. So if you are having any expectation related to SAR, you can post it in the chat box. Take 2 minutes of time, and if you are having anything related to SAR preparation, you can post it.
I request the faculty members, the participants, to post their queries in the chat box so that sir will resolve it.
Any expectation on SAR? If I know that, I would be able to emphasize on that. Okay, I don't see any. So let me start the session from my point of view.
Yes, sir, please start the session.
Yeah. From where to start the preparation of self-assessment report? So I think in the opening session, I have already given the hint. You should conduct the awareness program, training program. You should clarify the doubts of everyone, and then you should start it. Means then you should start the preparation. So you need to create a complete structure at institute level, department level, and program level, and even at section level to prepare self-assessment report. Okay, I'm happy that there are questions and which are coming up. Okay. So let me share the self-assessment report of tier two. This is the self-assessment report format. I have downloaded from NBA. Dear friends, now I am not able to see the chat. I am simply seeing my screens. So I will take up your questions later on. So dear friends, as you are aware, if you have gone through the self-assessment report, the structure of the self-assessment report. It is divided into three parts. So part A is institutional information. It is factual information. It is based on data, figure, and facts. So there could not be any variation in data, figures, and facts. Whatever information you have to put in this particular format. So this is part A. And I think there is nothing to understand here in part A. It is all factual information. Now coming to criterion B. Sorry, part B. If you look at part B, there are two types of criteria which are given in the self-assessment report. That is program level criteria and institute level criteria. For undergraduate tier 2 type of institutions, tier 2 means affiliating institutions. Tier 1 means institutions who design their own curriculum, who have their own examination system, and who award their own degree. So now we are talking about tier 2 institution, but I want to tell you that the philosophy for tier 1 or for PG program or for diploma program or for management program is same. So NBA works on the same philosophy, that is outcome based education. Okay, so program level criteria, vision, mission, and program educational objectives. For this criterion, there are 60 points. Program curriculum and teaching learning process, 120 points. Course outcomes and program outcomes, 120 points. Students' performance, 150. Faculty information, 200. Facilities and technical support, 80. And continuous improvement, 50. Similarly, at institute level, first year academics 50, student support systems 50, governance, institutional support, and financial resources 120. So generally, the evaluation for these criteria, three criteria at institute level, it is done by the chairman of the visiting committee. And for these seven criteria, the evaluation is done by the program specific expert. Now coming to the first criteria. How do you prepare the self-assessment report? So it requires a lot of homework. If I talk about state the vision, is it visible to you? If I talk about state the vision and mission of the department and institution, 5 points are there. Now, the vision and mission statement should be ready with you. What I want to submit that a proper process for crafting the vision and mission should have been followed, and the approved vision and mission statement should be available with you. Then only you can fill up the vision and mission of the department and institute here. And I think someone might have talked on it. You need to do SWOT analysis. You need to do creativity sessions. You need to do issue analysis. You need to do value analysis. You need to do the future requirements in your state. You need to consider your strengths. And on the basis of that, you come out with the vision and mission of the institute and vision and mission of the department. So if you have followed that process, then only you will get the points. Otherwise, you will not get the points. So 5 points are there. And I suppose you are also familiar with the evaluation guideline. If you are not, I will talk about that after discussing criterion one. So the whole process you have done in in creativity sessions, in discussions, in meetings, and the output is available with you. So you write the vision and mission of the department and of the institute. Then state the program educational objectives. Now at program level, at department level, you have NBA committee. So that committee considers each program, and for that, that committee involves the employers and external stakeholders, and it comes out with 3 to 5 program educational objectives. What is program educational objective? I think someone might have cleared you. If they have not cleared you, I will simply say that program educational objectives are the objectives of the program, means graduation plus gaining 3 to 5 years experience, what type of profession the individual pass out may handle effectively and efficiently. That is program educational objective. So this is not after graduation, but graduation plus gaining 3 to 5 years experience. So the roots of PEO should be there in your curriculum. So you need to craft 3 to 5 PEOs for the program, for each program. Then you need to indicate where you have published the vision, mission, and PEOs. So the guidelines are given here, that it should be published on institute website, so it should be available there. Then it should be available in departmental section of the institute website. There also it should be available. Then all that, then on all prominent places of the department, the vision, mission, and PEOs must be published in the chamber of the head of department, in laboratories, in workshops, everywhere this should be displayed. And this should be communicated through awareness workshop also to the students. So this is how you are publishing and disseminating the information related to vision, mission, and PEO. Whenever I go for visit in the institute, I simply ask this question: what is the vision of your department? And in 60% cases, I have found that people are not aware. Even the head of department is not aware. So how do I give marks? They have used cut and paste technology. So it is not known to them. And they don't know intent and spirit of crafting the vision and mission and PO. So even if it is there, I don't give the marks, because it is not for the display purpose. It is for releasing your energy, putting your time and effort. And if you don't know about it, why should I give you marks? So that is why I was saying that it is not the self-assessment report, but it is the achievement of implementation of the whole philosophy of outcome-based education. State the process for defining the vision and mission of the department and PEOs. There are people who use cut and paste technology. In some institutions, 1 or 2 persons formulate it. So others are not aware. So what will you write here? So I always say that from 1.4, it is called a TREP. So if you don't write the proper process here, we can very well make out that you have copied it, or 1 or 2 persons have crafted it, or a consultant has prepared it. So you don't get marks in 1.4, 1.3, 1.2, and 1.1. I simply want to say that based on the information in 1.4, we make out whether it is really crafted using proper process, or it is simply done casually. So if you don't do it, you won't get points. Then establish consistency of PEOs with the mission statement. And here I would like to say that it is iterative process. Means you craft the mission for the department, and you craft the vision, sorry, PEOs for the program, and after that you do the mapping. And after doing the mapping, you try to modify the or fine-tune the PEOs. Sometimes we also fine-tune the mission statements of the department also. So with this matrix, we do the fine-tuning of missions and fine-tuning of PEOs. And you may be aware that in NBA, this mapping philosophy is used, and it is based on the logic. And the mapping can be done on three levels: substantial, moderate, and slight. So suppose PEO1 is mapped with M2 at three level, means it is highly aligned to M2, like that. If I put 2, means it is contributing at 60% level or 70% level or like that. So this is how the map is prepared. So this is how the criterion 1 part of the self-assessment report is prepared. Dear friends, please give me 2 minutes. I want to show you the evaluation guideline also. I have shown you the question paper. Now I want to show you the model answer. Let me just open it. NBA has given the evaluation guideline also. So before filling the self-assessment report, you should go through the evaluation guideline also. I have opened this, is it visible, evaluation guideline?
Yes, sir.
So now you can see that in self-assessment report, you have seen 5 points are there for stating the vision and mission. But in evaluation guideline, it is further divided. Availability of the vision and mission, 1 point. Appropriateness and relevance of the statement. Consistency of the department statement with the institute statements, 2 points. So NBA has introduced so much of objectivity in the evaluation process. That is why NBA says that we are transparent and we are data-based. We are not governed by prejudices and preferences of the evaluators. So clear-cut guideline is given to the evaluators, and it is known to the institute also. So what I would like to submit, that before filling the self-assessment report, please refer the evaluation guideline also. So similarly, you will get for each and every sub-criteria of criterion 1. So this is how the guideline is provided. So if you consider the evaluation guideline and if you fill up this self-assessment report, it would be very helpful to you to properly articulate the sentences and properly write here. What I have seen in many institutions self-assessment report, they write a story. We don't want any story. We don't want anything in the form of paragraphs and essays. We want objective things so that we can evaluate objectively and we can give you right points for your achievements. So that doesn't happen when people use their common sense. So I would request you to refer each and everything, try to be systematic, and try to articulate the things in such a way so that the evaluation process becomes very easy for the evaluator. And at the same time, you communicate what you want to communicate. So communication we teach to our students, but communication for us is very, very important here. So with this, again, I am coming to you to respond to your questions.
Yes, sir. I think there are queries in the chat box. Shanu Tripathi, wants to ask, NB asked for the compliance report. How to distinguish it from the SAR?
Compliance report is after getting the accreditation. Suppose you got the accreditation for 3 years. So after 2.5 years, you again apply for the next cycle of accreditation. So for that, you fill up the compliance report after 2.5 years. And again, for the extension of the period. We'll talk about it later on. First, we try to understand the requirements of the self-assessment report. But yes, the process is written in the manual, and you have to go through the complete process of compliance. Formats are also available, but this compliance report is for them who has got accreditation for their programs after 2013, and their accreditation period is going to expire after 6 months. So you have to initiate that process.
Yes, sir. The next question is related to the classroom plan for the accreditation.
Classroom plan is in next criterion. I would respond to it. Next criterion.
Yes, for vision and mission, one question is, who will design the vision and mission, and what is the procedure for designing?
Madam, it requires half day session. Okay, in very brief, I want to tell you, BVM Engineering College is one of the oldest engineering college of Gujarat, 67 years old engineering college. They are all the society members, they have society, they have governing body. So all society members, all faculty members, all governing body members, more than 250 persons, we sat together, we conducted 3-day workshop in BVM, and we conducted lot many creativity sessions with 250 persons. More than 500 ideas were generated on future of the institute. Those ideas were analyzed, and based on that, tentative vision was crafted. After that, we did the SWOT analysis. On the basis of the results of the SWOT analysis, we fine-tuned the crafted vision. After that, we did the issue analysis, and on the basis of that, we fine-tuned the vision statement. After that, we did the value analysis, and based on that, we fine-tuned the vision statement. After that, that draft vision statement was communicated to everyone for comment, all internal and external stakeholders. So after scrutinizing all comments, again it was refined, then it was approved by the BOG and society. So we conducted 3-day workshop, lot many creativity sessions, SWOT analysis, issue analysis, value analysis was done, and everybody was at same level. And I came to know, I was the facilitator for that workshop. So I came to know that in the history of BVM, so many people met together for the first time for 3 days. We don't work in as a community. We all are learned people, so we try to work individually. So yeah, this is the process.
Yes, sir, you rightly pointed out, and I think very concisely you told about the whole process. That is about, first is about the idea analysis, about the future of the institution, then is SWOT analysis, then issue analysis, value analysis,
yeah.
Then compiling the statement, getting the feedback on the statements, and then finalization of the statement and approval by the BOG. So this is what the process you articulated. So I think we may continue with this, because PEO and POs, the question is there, but I think it is in the next criteria. So we'll be taking that.
Yeah, one more thing. I want to gift my book to all of you. The name of the book is Governance and Management of Technical Institutions. Written by me, B.L. Gupta. It is published by Concept Publishing Company. It is 600-page book. And it is available on Google Books free of cost. So those who are interested to learn about visioning in detail, they can refer chapter number 3 of my book. It is written for people like you only. Governance and Management of Technical Institutions by B.L. Gupta. It is available on Google Books free of cost. Okay. So how much time do I have? Up to 11:15 or 11:30?
11:15, sir. 11:30 is the next session.
Okay. So we can take up one more criterion. I am just giving you flavor. I think this would be helpful to you to prepare the self-assessment report, because in one session one cannot complete each and every aspect. Okay, so again I am sharing the screen, and I would like to discuss the criterion 2 of the self-assessment report. This is the evaluation guideline. So I would request every one of you to keep both the things simultaneously. On my desktop, I have a bigger screen, so I open both the things simultaneously. And I work on anything related to NBA accreditation. So self-assessment report and evaluation report should be referred simultaneously. Okay, friends, now coming to the criterion 2. I suppose you are enjoying my sessions, and I cannot introduce any humor because of shortage of time, and because of depth and breadth required in this particular process. Okay, coming to the criterion 2, program curriculum and teaching learning process, 120 points are there. The first criterion, okay. So I want to mention here that the structure of all criteria is same, and the structure is taken from the PhD thesis. So 2.1, 2.1.1, like that the structure is followed throughout the self-assessment report. Okay, program curriculum, 20 marks. State the process used to identify extent of compliance of the university curriculum for attaining the program outcome and program specific outcomes. Dear friends, as you are aware that 12 program level outcomes are already given, prescribed by NBA for undergraduate program, and these program outcomes are derived from the graduate attributes. Since the graduate attributes were being interpreted by different institutions and universities in different way, so now NBA transformed those graduate attributes in the form of PO, and now these 12 POs are common for all types of undergraduate engineering program, irrespective of the discipline. These are mentioned at the end of the self-assessment report. And I suppose you are aware about it. If you are not, this is the list. This is the last page of the self-assessment report. Engineering knowledge, problem analysis, design and development, conduct investigation, modern tool uses, engineer and society, environment and sustainability, ethics, individual and teamwork, communication, project management and finance, and lifelong learning. So we need to develop these 12 abilities in all graduates across the discipline. Okay. Plus, we need to formulate the PSO also, program specific outcome. So PO and PSOs are nothing, but these are the abilities which are expected to be possessed by all pass outs of your institute, and these abilities are related to world of work situation. So PEO is graduation plus 3 to 5 years experience. PO, program outcome. PO and PSO is immediately after graduation. So this is the difference between the PEO and PO and PSO. Okay, since you are affiliated with the university and the university has not revised the curriculum, so there could be curricular gap and content beyond syllabus. So that you need to identify, and you need to put in the table gap, action taken, date, month, year, resource person, kitne student the, and relevance of the gap with the PO and PSO. So this is how you need to identify the gap with respect to PO and PSO, and this gap you need to mention for previous 3 years. But this is a very common question to me in most of my training programs, that sir, for last 3 years we have not been doing these things. But I know that, but you are doing something. So those things try to document here and try to relate it with the PO and PSO. So suppose you have organized one industrial visit of 2 days in a very high-tech industry. So here you can mention gap, and that visit you can mention here, and rest of the things you can connect. It is related to PO number 2, like that. So this is how you can work in backward direction, and you can document the things. So there are two types of tables we need to prepare. One is gap. Gap means if I don't fulfill the gap, the students will not be able to develop that level of ability. That is a gap. And content beyond syllabus is that something has been developed, but it has not been commercialized. Means it has not come in market. Even if it has come in market, but it has not become a common practice. So that is content beyond syllabus. So something which is coming up, that can be considered as content beyond syllabus. Content beyond syllabus doesn't mean additional subject or what do you call extra classes. There are many people who are confused with it. It is not that. So these tables need to be prepared for 3 years. Dear friends, here I want to say that based on the assessment, the NBA assesses your performance of last 3 to 5 years, and NBA judge your quality, judge quality of education, and on the basis of that, it concludes that you have potential, means you are providing quality and you have potential to provide quality. So our past performance is assessed, and on the basis of that we get the certificate, and the certificate is for future. Okay, so this is how you fill up the table at department level, sorry, at program level. Then teaching learning process, 100 points are there. Describe processes followed to improve quality of teaching learning. 25 points are there. And I always say that please prepare a course plan for the whole course. Course means subject. NBA calls it course. And course may be theory, it may be practical, it may be workshop, it may be project, it may be internship, it may be anything. So I always request that at institute level, we should prepare a guideline document, and we should make aware every teacher, giving template also, to prepare a course file and course plan. And in the course plan, we can incorporate all these teaching learning methods against the contents. So very simple format may be used: serial number, content, then teaching learning method. If you wish to use media, the media, and you are well aware that outcome based education is student centric. So in the next column you can put the activity or task or assignment or micro project for the student, and then at the last you can have the assessment tool or technique. So this is how you can prepare the course plan, and same template may be used at the program level or maybe at the institute level, so that quality by design. Right from the beginning you know that this is the course plan, right from the beginning students know that this is the course plan, and right from the beginning your head of department and your principal knows that this is the course plan of BL Gupta. So you can get resources, you can get guidance, you can get support, and you can effectively and efficiently implement it. So I would request that please prepare a course plan. And dear friends, someone might have talked about the abilities. There are three types of abilities. One is related to cognitive domain, other one is related to affective domain, and third one is related to psychomotor domain. So for developing different types of abilities, we need to use different methods of teaching learning. So you need to use different methods of teaching learning, and there are more than 30 methods of teaching learning. So you should be able to select the right method. In traditional education system, we are using only one or two or three methods, and that too casually. So that should not happen. So this is how we can improve our classroom delivery and our quality of our academics, especially related to core courses of the curriculum. Then quality of, okay, if you have that, only then you will get the marks. If you write a story here, you are not going to get any mark. Quality of internal semester question paper, assignment, and evaluation. So again, it is outcome based. So we should frame the questions at higher level. And we should try to keep the evidences of implementation of outcome based education. So the focus should be HOTS and not LOTS. HOTS means higher order thinking skills. LOTS means lower order thinking skills. But if you see, most of the university papers describe, define, classify, distinguish, compare. Actually, all these questions are memory based. So they are testing LOTS, not HOTS. So we need to develop higher level questions. And I always recommend that we may pick up a situation from the world of work, and on that situation we may frame the question. Definitely that would be HOTS. We may give case study, small case study like that. So the whole system needs re-engineering actually. Then quality of internal test, question paper, assignment, evaluation. I'm sorry to say, our teachers are not trained to even give assignment. They give assignment which can be very well copied from the Google or from the textbook or from anywhere. So assignment means whatever they have learned, they should be able to apply the concept, principles, and like that. They should put efforts. They should refer 10, 20 reference material. Then only we'll say that they have done the assignment. It's not the output, but it's the process through which they go. They refer and they come across many things. Then quality of students project, this is very important. And this is, I would say in two sentences, this is the only direct and significant method which creates evidences for implementation of outcome-based education. So I would like to say you that at program level, before assigning the project, you should try to map the titles of the project with the PO and PSO. And in the title itself, you should try to incorporate the environmental aspect, safety aspect, sustainability aspect, economic aspect, and like that. If I take example of my B report, B project report long back, 38 years back, my title was Upgradation of Panchamukhi Fail. Panchamukhi Fail is a slum area. So that time it was conventional education system. So the title was highly oriented towards civil engineering. But if I want to assign the same title to my students, I will fine-tune the title in this way. Upgradation of Panchamukhi Fail, considering environmental, hygienic, and economic aspects. So what I have done, I have also covered the other POs which are not technical but associated POs. So I made it explicit in my title itself that you have not only to apply civil engineering, but you have to apply the other aspects also, like environment, maybe hygiene, and maybe economics. There could be few more. So what I would like to submit, that the project title or project theme or project problem should be designed properly. Then initiatives related to industry interaction, 15 points are there. Again, it should not be a casual approach. In most of the institutions, it is a casual approach. Since you are going for quality certification, so it should not be casual approach. It should be a part of your academic plan. Then internship is a must so that they get hands-on. So this is how we fill up the criterion 2 requirement of self-assessment report. And I'm sure all the teachers must be trained to design and implement the course plan, which is student-centric and which is implementing the concept of outcome-based education in letter and spirit. So this is what I wanted to share with you with respect to criterion 2. This is the, again, evaluation guideline. So I would suggest you to please go through the evaluation guideline also and then start preparing at your program level. Then you will be able to successfully articulate or frame the sentences, and you will be able to put them in the self-assessment report, and that will be rightly or appropriately assessed by the team. Otherwise, what happens, you will write the story or you will write irrelevant things, which is not acceptable to the NBA team. We can very well make out that you are trying to camouflage the information, you don't know it, and you don't have systems, and you are simply filling the self-assessment report. So, dear friends, with this, I think I am able to manage the time. I have talked about you on criterion 1 and 2, and now I'm open to respond to your questions related to criterion 2.
So, thank you very much, sir. One thing I would like to mention, we not only learned about the SAR, we also learned how to effectively manage an online session, because you managed this online session so beautifully, because in this time we all are conducting so many online sessions as a teachers, but how an effective session can be managed, you demonstrated actually. So this is the one more thing which I got from this, how the effectiveness can be enhanced, so balanced at a what kind of pauses, at what length we need to interact. So everything was so balanced. and I was continuously noticing, and that's why I would like to give you this compliment. Most of our teachers are benefited through this your live demonstration, because you demonstrated it very beautifully. So I think the questions are
thanks for the compliments. Teachers are the role model.
Yes sir, because it is you are leading by the example, you are telling by the example. So
yeah, questions please.
Yes sir. How to match the teachings, it is related to basically the mapping. I think question is not very clear, but it is related to the mapping of outcomes with the curriculum.
Atul Gupta's question?
Yes, it is the question from Ms. Ruchi Sharma.
Okay, what is the exact question, can you tell me?
I think question is not clear. It is related to the mapping of course outcomes.
Question is clear to me.
Yes, sir.
Suppose I want to develop safety related ability in our students. So ability cannot be developed through lecture or demonstration. Safety is related to affective domain skill, and affective domain skills comes through practice. So I would say that for developing safety, we need to give input, maybe in the form of self-learning, then demonstration, then role play, then simulation, then practice, then practice, feedback, practice, feedback, practice, feedback, then it becomes your habit. So for different types of abilities, different methods are required. It requires very high level of training, I tell you. That is why I told you that we conduct 8 weeks training for newly recruited teachers. And that training is enjoyed by people who retired and having age of 72 years and have been principals and attended our training program. They said that ye to mujhe 21 saal ki umr mein karna tha. It's like that. So for different abilities, different methods are suitable, like that. So if I want to teach hygienic practices or safety or concern for environment, traditional methods are not going to work. I need to use appropriate method, as I told you. And it's a mix of methods, right from self-learning, demonstration, role play, simulation, simulated condition, then practice, feedback, and sometimes the safety related ability is very dangerous. So sometimes very close guidance is required. That is why practice, feedback in risk-free situation, then only we'll be able to develop the ability. And that is what the outcome is. If I talk about pharmaceutical industry, the quality of drug or medicine is very, very important. And if we don't develop quality assurance ability in our pharmacy passouts, then it may create havoc. Lakes of tablets are spread throughout the world. It may create havoc. It may have ill effect on the health of the people. So different types of abilities are developed using different methods. But the thing is that most of our teachers are not trained, so they use traditional methods. Thank you. So that is the mapping of the methods with the CO and PO and with the content. Any other question, please? I suppose I have responded it well.
Yes, sir. Very beautifully you responded to each and every query. I think we can conclude this session now. And if the participants are left with some query, we are having one more session with you on tomorrow. So they can have the query on tomorrow's session as well.
Sure.
So thank you very much, sir. It was a very beautiful session. And I think you can just read the compliments and the comment remarks which we are getting in the chat box. So everything was very beautifully covered. I too agree with this. The topic that is complete SAR is not been possible to be covered in the period of 1.5 hours. So it is very difficult, but in the way you managed, it is very effective and it is very beautiful. So once again, thank you very much, sir, for your time, for your concern, and for your valuable informations which you have shared with us. So thank you very much, sir, and we would like to see you very soon for tomorrow's session.
Sure, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.